Hola y bienvenidos. Yo soy señora Nelson y estoy aquí para ayudarles a aprender el español. Now, this video is specifically for the poor souls who need to survive a Spanish final. And if you're watching this one with hubiera and habría and all that, oof, this is probably Spanish 4 or AP and I'm so sorry and I feel your pain. I really hope this video does help. Let me know in the comments what else would help, how you have handled subjunctive verbs, brusco and perfecto, all of that. And we're all in this together. You'll do great. You will pass it. I believe in you. And I'm here for you. Entiendo, I've been there. I had to survive those finals too. It was rough, but I got through it. And then I could just study Spanish as I wanted. So you're almost there. Buena suerte. You're going to do great. Today, I would love to help you guys with subjunctive crazy pluscuamperfecto verbs. Now, when I was in Al Saber, maybe Spanish 4, maybe AP, no recuerdo. Hace muchos años, I had to learn all of the different types of subjunctive. And then we got into the coulda, woulda, shoulda, all of that. Once we got into these verbs, I've already learned every normal verb. I've already learned every subjunctive verb. Now I'm learning verbs in the past tense. Now I'm learning the double negatives and doubtful and who knows what and this could have, would have, should have happened and all of that. And I wanted to cry. And then my teacher taught us hubiera, habría. The beautiful thing of hubiera and habría is it's just like the present perfect. You learn present perfect, oof, who knows when, right? Es, a, hemos, han. And then you have the ado, ido, and there's some irregulars. Has visto, things like that, right? If that is pretty solid in your brain, when you're learning the crazy, weird subjunctive of the past, maybe, and the whatever, stick with hubiera and habría. They're little pals. They always go together. If this would have happened, we wouldn't have done this. If this wouldn't have happened, we would have done this. Who knows what? Hubiera, habría. And they're conjugated super simple. Hubiera, hubieras, hubiera, hubiéramos, hubieran. Habría, habrías, habría, habríamos, habrían. And they're always side by side. Just as a subjunctive and imperfect would be. However, instead of thinking of two separate verbs of how do you conjugate this verb with this verb and how do I say this with this and my brain's already smoking, hubiera, habría. Keep it simple. You know you're perfect, your present perfect, your past perfect. You know all of those verbs super well. Now, use them to your advantage. When you're doing the coulda, woulda, shoulda, hubiera, habría. Every single time. Si no hubiera ido al super, no habría comprado los chips. Whatever. Si no hubiera estudiado, no habría pasado mi examen final. It works every single time and it helps you kind of avoid all of the conjugations that you're really stressed to do when it comes time for the final. Now, in the comments, I want to hear what has helped you survive subjunctive verbs and the Spanish final. What are tips you have for us? I'll see you guys next week.